I want to get us back in line. We had July 4th, and then last week we had special speakers. And there's been just a lot of stuff going on. If you took one of those surveys, though, and haven't filled that out yet, please do so and get a hold of Deb and I so we can sit down and talk with you. You know, everybody who's done those, and we've sat down there, it's just been amazing, the response and the encouragement that we've seen from them. I believe spiritual gifts are different than our talents. I believe the day you accept Christ into your heart and His Holy Spirit comes in, He deposits within you a gift. And that gift is to help the church body grow and to prosper into what it should be. Our talents can help. The gifts are needed. The gifts come as only the Spirit can give them. Like I said, I believe at the moment we accept Christ, these gifts are planted. Jamie and I were talking on the way up here. We remember the West Unity Parade in June, and we spoke how some of the corn was only yay tall, and we weren't sure if it would be knee-high by the 4th. We had that conversation. Well, I took a picture of Jake standing on the edge of a cornfield last Sunday, and it was about 2 feet over his head. It's exploded! Those farmers know what they're doing, don't they? They know when to plant it. They know how to plant it. They know when to fertilize, when to cultivate, when to get that corn in such a way that it can just explode. And that's what God's Holy Spirit does to us. He knows when to plant it. He knows how to plant it. The rest is up to us. You see, through studying and meditating and praying on this word, that gift begins to grow. And then one day, it explodes and becomes full into what we need. The church is known as the Bride of Christ. Beautiful, waiting for Him. And it takes all of us together to grow a place into becoming pleasing to God and our Lord. This morning, I would like us to realize something, and that is all these gifts are different than others. Look around. Do you see an identical twin? We're all different, aren't we? God's gifts are also different because they're needed for different kinds of service. Some might be able to mow grass. Some might clean toilets. See, that's a gift of hospitality, preparing a place for those who come. Some might be able to speak. Some might be able to pray and see God's hand at work. The thing we need to understand is, although the gifts are different, there's none better than the other. Every single one is needed and is meaningful within the church. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 4 through 11 says this. There are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit distributes them. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them and in everyone, it is the same God at work. Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good. To one there is given us through the Spirit a message of wisdom. To another a message of knowledge by means of the same Spirit. To another faith by the same Spirit. To another gifts of healing by that one Spirit. To another miraculous powers. To another prophecy. To another distinguishing between spirits. To another speaking in different kinds of tongues. And to still another the interpretation of tongues. All these are the work of one and the same Spirit. And He distributes them to each one just as He determines. Let's pray. Father God, we thank You for Your word. We thank You, Lord, that we can come together this morning and be united together, partaking of communion and remembering Your Son. Lord, we just ask that You be with us now as we continue to study and learn from Your Spirit. Father God, we ask that You be with us and guide us and direct us in everything we do and say. For we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. How many know we're all unique? We all got different things, don't we? About 1:30 a.m. in the morning, I get the hankering for Taco Bell. I'm sorry. I do. Now my wife doesn't. And when she hears the rappers out in the living room and all the noises that I make as I'm enjoying that wonderful double crunch chalupa, she's really quick to communicate to me what a crazy person I am. We're all different. We all have uniquenesses about us, but they come from the same Spirit. Words of encouragement, words of hope. Together, we can make the body of Christ pleasing to God. Philippians chapter 2, verses 12 through 18 says this to us. Therefore, my dear friends, as you have always obeyed, not only in my presence, but now much more, in my absence, continue to work out your salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who works in you to will and to act in order to fulfill His good purpose. Do everything without grumbling or arguing, so that you may become blameless and pure, children of God without fault, in a rapt and crooked generation. Then you will shine among them like stars in the sky as you hold firmly to the word of life. And then I will be able to boast on the day of Christ that I did not run or labor in vain. But even if I am being poured out like a drink offering on the sacrifice and service coming from your faith, I am glad and rejoice with all of you. So you too should be glad and rejoice with me. I seen two words in there that caught my attention when I was reading that. Grumbling. An attitude. Growing up, we had to take turns doing dishes. I wasn't much of a dish-doing guy. So I'd give my sisters, each of them, a nickel to do dishes for me. Back then, a nickel meant a little bit. You could get a candy bar at Uncle Bob's grocery store for a nickel. And they would. But if they wouldn't, Dan was grumbling, had an attitude. And how can that be pleasing to God? If he's asked us to be happy and glad and to rejoice in what he is doing within us, why do we let such minor physical things transpose our way of thinking and become ornery? Something to think about. Something to challenge yourself with. God is at work within us. He will accomplish his purposes. You see, the Corinthians, when Paul wrote this, had elevated more spectacular gifts and were given more attention to spiritual superstars. But Paul challenges them to incorporate the diversity of gifts with our understanding. The same God at work in us all, but he customizes each one of us for the strength of the church. A few Sundays ago, we had a carry-in lunch, and we enjoyed a wonderful time of dedication. And as I was thinking about this, I jotted down some of the gifts that are on our survey sheets and how the response would be if something happened. Let's say somebody got a big old plate full of desserts and dropped it. Here's what would happen. A person with the gift of prophecy would say, "That's what happens when you're not careful." How many of you thought of that right away? Some of you did. A person with the gift of service would say, "Oh, let me help you clean that up." A person with the gift of teaching would explain the reason why it fell was because one side was much heavier than the other side. Huh? A person with the gift of exhortation would say, "Next time maybe you should let someone carry that for you." A person with the gift of giving would say, "Here, you can have my dessert." A person with a gift of mercy would say, "Don't feel so bad. It could have happened to anyone." A person with the gift of administration would say, "Jim, get the vacuum. Sue, pick up. Mary, could you get him another dessert?" Would right away start thinking of ways to solve the problem and get it cleaned up in a timely fashion. Some of those statements rang true to you as you're sitting here this morning. And that's where your gifting lies. Don't be afraid of it. Walk in it. Allow God to minister to you and build that. Embrace it and allow God to work through you. How many of you know there's a rainbow at the end of most storms in life? Amen? Kip, we talked about that, didn't we? I ran across this song by Maudrey Stewart that talks about a rainbow. I'd like to play that for you this morning.
Rainbow at the end of every storm. Ooh, when troubles and trials stand in your way. When you get to where it's free, look to the sky, reach for his arm. There's a rainbow at the end of every storm. Whether it's sickness, whether it's death, when your heart is heavy, can't find peace nor rest, when the clouds of doubt all around you fall, He is the rainbow at the end of every storm.
Well, he's the
rainbow at the end of every storm.
Ooh. He's the rainbow at the end of every storm. We just need to trust him. Lean on him, walk with him, and he'll guide us and direct us. Amen?
Amen?
Let's pray. Father God, we thank you this morning, Lord. We thank you that we were able to come out this morning and hear your word, Lord, both in song and spoken. Father God, that you allowed us the opportunity to take communion and remember your son in a unique and special way. Lord, we just pray that you bless our steps today, that you allow our Sunday school hour to be meaningful and that we can grow from it, Father. Lord, we pray that we'll draw closer to you today. We pray this all in Jesus' name. We all said, amen. Thank you all, folks.